Hey everyone, Ricky here from Ricky's Tech Talk. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the Honor 50, and we're going to be taking a look at the accessibility settings and options in greater detail. And this is a vast improvement on some of their previous devices because Google services have returned. This also includes their accessibility settings, as Google owns the patents and rights to the accessibility settings, which I only recently found out once Honor had removed Google services. It had lost that services. So it's nice to know the settings are back. So let's go through the settings and features that you can change and adjust to make this device your own. As you may know, I'm registered blind myself. That's why having a 6.5 inch display on the Honor 50 really helps. A bigger display is a lot easier to use for me. But let's go through the settings and the options. A side note here is when you go through the setup process, you do have options to either turn on Talkback, which is a voice assistant option, or you have the option of changing some settings. Enough said, now let's go through those features, starting with Talkback. So make sure your volume is all the way up and press and hold both of them together at the same time.
Talkback on. Honor Home. Weather. Double tap and hold to long press.
So as you know, it tells you everything. So Talkback is a great service. So first of all, you can go through applications.
Honor Store. Honor Club. Settings. Gallery. Folder. Google. Play Store. Calendar. Optimizer. Camera. Double tap to activate. Double tap and hold to long press.
So it gives you feedback of what you need to do. If you want to maneuver around your display, use two fingers and swipe
screen
left or right.
Two.
So, and we can go the other way.
Discover. Button. Hit a button like
and
like
I can scroll up and down.
Enter assistant today. Honor Home.
So using two fingers to manipulate your way through the device left or right. This also can be used to go up or down by using two fingers. And as you saw there, I went through the Google feed to hear the latest news. You could tap on article and hear everything back. You can also go up to your taskbar at the top here.
System UI 1445. Ringer vibrate. Battery 100%.
So Talkback is a great service and it's really nice to see this back on the device because the Google Mobile Services is back on this device. And that means that Google have brought back the accessibility settings. So this makes the device more accessible. To turn Talkback off, press and hold the volume keys again, both of them together.
Talkback off.
Talkback is now off, and let's go into settings and find out more accessible options that we have here. So we could ask Google to launch into that if we wanted to, but I want to just show you where it is. So tap the gear icon, which is for settings. Scroll all the way down to the bottom. And down here at the bottom, we have accessibility features. So it's on the main list, which is nice to see. It is at the bottom, but that's okay. We can forgive that. And inside here, we have a range of options. Some that you will get to know quite easily, and you should see in my other previous videos. And some are new to certain devices. So we're going to go into accessibility. So the first of all, it's broken up into sections. We've got audio. We've got Talkback, which I've gone through already, but you can go inside here and you can go in and change the settings and change options if you so wish to. So tap more settings. And as you can see, there's a range of settings there. If you turn on Talkback for the first time, it will go through a tutorial and will take you a step-by-step guide through the tutorial. Because I've turned it on and checked it's worked with this device, I haven't been able to show you that tutorial. Our next option underneath is select to speak. So tap this, we're going to toggle on. Again, you get settings. Once toggled on, you've got a fourth icon down here at the bottom. And I do recommend having the controls down here at the bottom. The gesture feature is okay to have, but you may not have access to this option here. So once toggled on, tap the accessible person. You can either press play or touch anywhere to hear it being read back to you.
Navigate up. Select to speak. Select to speak. More settings. About. Nope.
So select to speak is slightly different than Talkback. Talkback will narrate everything back to you no matter where you are. Select to speak is in the name. You select what you want to be spoken. This is really helpful for when it comes to long emails or long text messages. So select to speak is a nice option. And again, it's good to see it on this device. I'm just going to toggle off if it wants to go off. The next option is text to speech. And inside here, you can change your speech rate or your pitch. So they're both on their default, and this is what it sounds like.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
Someone like myself, who's visually impaired, will be a lot faster because they use it every single day.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
So that was exactly the same sentence, but a lot quicker. And you can change the pitch, and you can reset both here if you want to. But again, that's helpful to have. Underneath that, we have mono audio, so you can select have mono audio. Underneath that, you have captions, and you have the ability to change captions. We've got language, text size, and caption style. So you can go in there and choose captions, which I think is really helpful. And then for me, this is my section here, being visually impaired. I want to change some settings inside here. So first of all is color correction. We can change the color correction. The next one is magnification. So we're going to turn magnification on. Then with three quick taps on the display, you'll zoom in and you can then move around your display with two fingers. You can even pinch in. And with having a large OLED panel with over a billion colors with a resolution of 1080 by 2340, this really helps when it comes to reading text, especially on this large 6.57 inch display. 1, 2, 3 to come back. There is also another option, three quick taps, hold on the third tap, and you can zoom in very quickly. 1, 2, 3, it will zoom in for you. You can use one finger to go wherever you want, so maybe I wanna just check the time, my battery, release, and it jumps out again. You don't have to tap to come out. Really nice option to see there. That's very helpful when it comes to emails, or if I need to see something maybe I've taken a photo of. Underneath that, you've got a large mouse pointer, so you can use a mouse pointer if you want to. So you can connect a Bluetooth mouse and use that with your smartphone. So underneath that, you have color inversion. So this will actually invert your colors. Let's go home. It inverts the colors, very different to dark mode, which I'll explain about a little bit later on. So let's just jump back here, and if I turn this off, it'll go back to its normal pre-setting. And as you can see, there was a clear difference there. You have high contrast text. This makes it bolder and easier to see. If you look at this text under advanced visual effects, it slightly changes when I press the high contrast text, making it easier for you to read. Then you do have your advanced visual effects that you can turn on or off. Then in interaction control, you have switch access. I love this setting. This gives you the ability to use switches and controls with your smartphone to navigate around your phone and use it any way you want to. If you are unable to, with controls and smart switches, you can have full access of your phone. A very good setting there, and I really like to make a video on that. Underneath that, you have accessibility shortcuts, and that is preset to Talkback. You've got touch and hold delay, that's for dexterity and interaction with your smartphone. And click when cursor stops, again, that's if you're using the mouse with your smartphone. You've got power button to end the calls, if you want to use your power button to end the calls. And then you have a section here for downloaded services. So that's all that you see in the accessibility settings. Just want to pause here though for a second, because being registered blind, it's so nice to see the high level of settings returning to the Honor 50. And that's all thanks to the Google services also returning to this device, which makes the Honor 50 series more accessible and easier to use. And I can highly recommend it. In this section, they also have their own settings. You've got one-handed mode. So if we go in here and you can scroll along the bottom and it'll pinch down into the corner. And as you can see here, you've got it in the bottom corner, making it really easy then, because it is a large display, just tap and you can come back. I really like the one hand mode. You've got shortcuts and gestures that you can use. So you have the option to take a screenshot and you can just tap with your knuckle, take a screenshot, that's really nice, or pull down with three fingers. Next is the option to start a screen record. That takes two knuckles on your display. So there we go. And we can able to screen record, so we can, while using, okay. And then we've got the settings here for screen record, got it. And it's already started. I'm just going to stop that there. So the next option is to wake your display. So if I lock it here, raise up and it'll wake up, or I can double tap and it will wake up as well for me, which is really handy. Swipe up and we can use the facial recognition that we have in the sort of O-dot inbuilt camera here. The next one is to mute ringtone or reduce volume, either by flipping your phone over or by picking it up, it will do that. Again, that's a nice option. and answer calls as well, raised to your ear, and it will answer your call for you automatically. Underneath that, we've got the missed touch prevention, which is really handy because of a large display. Sometimes you accidentally press and you don't mean to. We've got scheduled power on and off. One other option you may want to go to here is system navigation. So inside here, you've got the three key navigation. We have four with the accessibility figure, or you've got the gesture control and you can try the gestures. I would prefer just having the three buttons or the four buttons along the bottom. So that's everything that we find in accessibility. Scrolling up to the top, or you could type in the search section, I just want to show you display, because in display there's a little bit more you can change. First of all is your brightness, and we've got automatic, or you can set your own. You've got color mode and temperatures. Again, you can go in here and change the hue of the display depending what works best for you. Again, someone visually impaired, that's helpful. Sleep time, so mine is set to 10 minutes and then the device will go to sleep and turn off the display. But for me, I have that quite long because I'm either filming, talking, or using my device. You've got eye comfort control here that you can turn on or off. And that's really good to see that's back on the device as well. You've got something new here, which is ebook mode. And as you can see, it grays it out, making it really easy. That's really good if you want to read a book, an ebook, or read emails. You have dark mode, which is different to color inversion. So if I toggle dark mode on here, it will change everything dark in the menus, the systems, but the colors stay the same wherever you go. And again, some applications will change automatically, some won't, depending how they've set up and gone through the system. So coming back into here, we're just gonna toggle dark mode off at the moment because I started it in the default settings, but I just want to show you that option. Text and display size, I've changed it slightly so I can read it. So one other one is your screen refresh rate. This is where it will automatically dynamically change your screen refresh rate, 120 hertz, really fast, fluid motion. What that means is when you scroll up and down, it just works very quickly, very smoothly now. Most phones have 120 hertz, even including newer devices from likes of Apple and Samsung have that now. And it's really nice it's made it to the Honor 50. There is a Pro variant, but it's nice it's on the Honor 50 as well. You've got more display options that you can go inside here and change as well if you want to. And it has suggested ones down here at the bottom. So simple mode, really nice. Large key options, so just press and use your device. And also you have the always on display, which I like because it gives me information and notifications because I receive so much here from the channel and my other social media platforms. Coming back home, it's time to sort of think about what this device offers and is it right for you. Big tick that the Google services has returned, because I didn't realize that Google took away the accessibility options when you lost the Google Play Store and the Google services. A huge tick there for Honor for getting the Google services back and including the Google accessibility settings, such as the Talkback, the magnification, select to speak, and all of the other options I've gone through. However, you may have some questions and queries, and the best way to get in touch is by leaving a comment below underneath the like button on this video. So make sure to give this video a like. Also, please let me know what other videos you would like to see on the Honor 50 while I have it in hand. From me, Ricky, thank you very much for watching, and I appreciate you watching this video and I hope it has helped. If you have enjoyed this video on the Honor 50, make sure to subscribe to stay updated when I release new videos. From me, stay safe, stay well, and I will see you in my next video.